What happens to significant figures when we perform mathematical operations? If we multiply or divide two values, the significant figures in the answer equals the significant figures in the least precise measurement. For example, if we multiply 3.54 times 72.163, our calculator says the answer is 255.457020. However, we do not just write down all of the numbers the answer in our calculator gives us. We look at the number of significant figures of the numbers we multiplied. 3.54 has three significant figures, while 72.163 has five significant figures. Our final answer needs the number of significant figures in our least precise measurement, so the answer is 255, which has three significant figures. If we add or subtract values, the result has the same number of decimal places as the least precise measurement. For example, if we add 1.04 plus 2.7, our calculator says the answer is 3.74. 1.04 has two significant figures after the decimal, while 2.7 has one significant figure after the decimal. This means our answer needs one significant figure after the decimal and is 3.7. When we obtain our final answer, we may need to round it to have the correct number of significant figures. The rules for rounding are as follows. 1. Keep all digits until the final result and then round. So until you get to the final answer in your calculator, it is fine to keep working with the full numbers. Do not round at each step. 2. When you have the final answer, if the digit you're going to remove is less than 5, round down, but if it is greater than or equal to 5, round up. So, for example, 3.74 becomes 3.7 to two significant figures, whereas 3.75 becomes 3.8 to two significant figures. So, let's summarize. To multiply or divide, use the significant figures of the least precise value. To add or subtract, use the number of decimal places of your least precise value. And if you need to round in order to get your answer to the correct amount of significant figures, wait until you get to your final answer.
Nilay's chemistry.